Hey, what's up? This is Brian Pfeiffer, the owner of BachelorVegas.com. And I'm standing here today, guys, in front of Hakkasan. You can kind of see in the background there. There's the big symbol right next to Hakkasan Restaurant. And this video, I'm going to talk about Hakkasan and getting into this place and the bottle service, okay? I'm doing a little update video for you guys. Hakkasan, just so you guys know, that's my my Vegas home, okay? I came out here because of Hakkasan. I was originally a big promoter in Chicago for like 12 years. And Hakkasan was kind of recruiting and, you know, bringing in some of the best people in the country to help open this place. At the time, it was the largest, most expensive nightclub in Las Vegas and in the world. So I got to be a part of that. That was, you know, some scandal back in the day with some, I believe it was Abu Dhabi money, and at the time it was AMG Group, and ended up being Hakkasan Group, and you know, I was there through kind of the whole thing. So it was pretty cool. You know, I got a lot of little heart for this place. I was a promotions manager here for Hakkasan and Wet Republic for a year, a little over a year, and then I went off and started my own company. So if you want to get into this place, okay, they have a couple of different options. Is you know, they got the guest list. You can get on above or below. I'll have a link for that, and tickets as well, above or below. I do sell tickets for the Tao Group now that owns this place or operates this place. And then, of course, got the bottle service, okay? And that's generally kind of what I specialize in. We do some bottle service and VIP entries here once in a while. Bottle service tonight, I have a customer at 10:30 coming in for an upper dance floor, all right? And let's talk about the different table options. Just a little bit about the music. Okay, generally, they're going to be an EDM club. They're going to be open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And the DJs, they got a pretty good lineup this year. They did bring back Tiesto for some shows. I think he's going to be here a couple times. They're kind of splitting him with Liv, and obviously they got, you know, Tao, Beach, and Omnia, and Wet Republic. So I think they got him for maybe 20 shows, and he might be here a couple times. I haven't looked at the full schedule yet for the rest of the year. I don't know if it's out yet. But you know, you got Alesso, he's going to be here once in a while. You got Stevie Aoki. You got guys like Little John. You know, they got a pretty good lineup, okay? Martin Garrix is one of the Tao Group residents. I'm not sure if he's going to be here at all this year, but you know, you might get a show or two out of him for you know, the upcoming season or so. But their DJs are pretty good. All right, now they don't really have enough DJs to fill all their venues every night with EDM, so you're going to find some nights where they're going to have some hip hop here. All right, so just pay attention to the link below for the above or below for the events. You know, I might find a Tyga here, or a Fat Joe, or an OT Genesis. They do have some hip hop artists on their roster, so those are going to be more like hip hop nights. When Little John's here, they kind of does a mix of everything. Okay, Paulie D's also one of the residents, kind of does a mix of everything. All right. Now, as far as the bottle service goes, generally it's going to mostly always be in the main room, okay, the main DJ. And then they usually have the pavilion room open, which is kind of attached to the main room. It's all one big room, same music. They originally sectioned that off to be kind of a separate club if they ever wanted to. Out of all the 11 years that I've been a part of this place, I've never seen them do it except for once. So I think that was kind of a waste of time and money. They should have just made it an extension of the main room. And then there's also a mezzanine level on the main room. So you get the mezzanine level, the pavilion, and then the main room, which is going to be make up your main room. All right, and then below that, one floor down, you got what's called the Ling Ling Lounge, which is a smaller little, like, maybe 100-person club. I've actually rented it out for some corporate events a couple times. And then you got the Ling Ling Club, which is generally when they have an EDM artist upstairs and they're busy enough, they would open up the Ling Ling Club, and that would be the hip-hop club. When they typically don't really have, like, hip-hop artists, but they'll have like a hip hop open format DJ in there, and it's a nice relief. You can go down one stairs and have a whole different vibe and whatnot. But nowadays, you know, there's a lot of competition, and the, you know, the market isn't what it was back in the day for the clubs. I think they really rarely open the third floor on big nights. Like if you have a Tiesto here, you can probably count on it being open, or maybe even a Alesso. But you know, even that's not a guarantee that they're going to have that third floor open. So this video, I'm going to focus mainly on the main room, the mezzanine, and the pavilion. I will mention some of the other sections, but if you're looking for bottle service, you know, arguably the best tables in the club are going to be your stage tables. Those are going to be the 1 through 4 tables on the right and the left of the DJ. Very high demand. I had the Super Bowl here a couple weeks ago, and I had some NFL players that did one of those tables. It was $30,000 minimum, $42,000 with tip and tax. So those are pretty popular. So those are good. I definitely recommend those if you want to be up close to the DJ and enjoy the show on maybe one of those hip-hop artist nights. The dance floor tables are going to be the big horseshoe. I believe there's 10 of them. with the two being in the middle going to be your owner's tables. Okay, those are going to be like basically the center two tables. I think it's 51 and 61. And then the two behind there, the upper dance floor tables, those are also considered the owner's tables. Okay, so there's four owner's tables. You can let me know if you're interested in one of those and which one you'd like. You want the upper one that's raised above or the lower one? All right. And then you got your upper dance floor tables, which are also very good. They're also in the horseshoe. What I like about the stage tables and then the upper and lower dance floor tables, you got to get the effect of the main room when they blow off the confetti. You know, you get some of the confetti into your table. They got that Hakkasan grid, which is really cool. Really good light show. Now, once you go back from there, you're going to get into your third, fourth row tables. Now, those are going to be a row of third row tables. There's a couple bigger ones that are like big U's. I believe it's 31 to 32. And those are good for like groups of 10 to 12. A lot of action around those tables. Front and back of you, those are really good. And then there's, you know, I think a 31 to 35. That's going to be... 30 to 35, that's going to be the other third row tables. And there's 42 A and B right behind there, which are good tables, a little bit elevated behind the third row. And then there's another couple tables, I think it's like 41 A and B, that are kind of, we call that the penalty box back there. But some people like those tables. There's a lot of action in that walkway there on the way to the bathroom. And that kind of completes your main floor, main room, okay? Above that is going to be your mezzanine level, and then they have that kind of broken up into different sections. You're going to have your center mezzanine tables. Those are going to be your premium tables up there. Then you're going to be on the side mezzanines are going to be your next level, and then you have like the skybox tables. Okay, those are basically to the right and the left. They're pretty big and roomy, good for big groups, but the view's kind of crappy from up there. You're kind of looking at the DJ from the back, and they're kind of off in the corners. So, you know, if you got a self-contained group and you just want to have a big party, those are pretty good. On New Year's Eve, I had a group of like 30 people. They ended up getting a skybox up there and had a great time. So, you know, people can have a good time up there. I've been up there and had some good parties as well. So, not bad. Now you got the pavilion, which is going to be like the extension of the other side of the club, basically the third row, which is considered the front row pavilion. Those are good tables. A little bit less than the third and fourth row tables typically, because you got a walkway there for like the handicap accessible. There's like a ramp there, so it's a little bit further back. And then behind that, you're going to have your second row pavilion tables, and then there's a third row pavilion tables, and then there's kind of like your back wall pavilion tables. Now, the back wall pavilion tables, there's some of them that are kind of tucked away in the corner. You can't see anything from back there. You're looking at a wall. So, you know, real busy night, they're going to seat those for the lowest minimums on the main floor. Some nights they don't even see them because they just don't have enough tables. But that's going to be kind of like your pavilion. If you go down to the third floor, like I said, that isn't open all that much anymore. That's going to be the Ling Ling Club. You're going to have some DJ booth sort of tables, and we call them dance floor DJ booth tables. Those are going to be your prime tables that are around the dance floor, and then there's kind of like a second row and a third row of tables. They're all good tables. Like, if the Ling Ling Club was in any other city in the country, like, say, for example, Chicago, that club, exact club, that layout opened up in Chicago, would be the best club in the city. It's a cool layout. It's just, you know, unfortunately, they just don't have enough people these days to fill it. And then the Ling Ling Lounge is just going to be kind of like a lounge with some cool tables along the wall, and there's some in the middle as well. Again, they only really use that these days for corporate events. So if you're interested in a corporate event, you've got 100, 150 people, we can maybe do the Ling Ling Lounge, get it catered, the Hakkasan Restaurant night downstairs, do like an open bar. Works out pretty good. So hopefully you guys understand everything that I mentioned here in Hakkasan. I do have a 3D map now that's interchangeable with the events. Shows the pricing and everything right on my website. Go right on the table, see a picture of the table. Click on it and then check out. I also own a hotel booking company, so if you need deals on rooms, you got a big group coming out. I do a lot of big bookings. I just did a massive one for Caesars Entertainment. It was 186 grand, so it's a pretty big one. But I do have packages as well that include like the dinner, limo service, you know, men's shows for the ladies, strip clubs for the guys, and we do all that here out here in Las Vegas. And, you know, of course, I just do the straight up bottle service. So make sure you hit me up. My cell phone's above 773-459-8133. That's my cell phone. And hit me up if you have any questions. And I look forward to working with you out here in Las Vegas. Make sure you like this video if you like the content and appreciate what I do out here. Make sure you subscribe to this channel for more and bang the notifications bell. I'm Brian Pfeiffer, and I'm looking forward to working with you out here at Hakkasan in Las Vegas. Let's talk soon. Bye.